Hello guys, welcome to Newzee. Leaders of the Asia-Pacific Trade Group, APEC, including US President Joe Biden, Russia's Vladimir Putin, and China's Xi Jinping, pledged on Friday to work to expand sharing and manufacturing of COVID-19 vaccines to fight the global pandemic.
The leaders, struggling to tame outbreaks exacerbated by the Delta variant of the coronavirus, said they would encourage the voluntary transfer of vaccine production technologies on mutually agreed terms as the region prepared for future health shocks.
新西兰有一句毛利谚语：“当你面向太阳，阴影终将消散。”我们对人类合作战胜疫情充满信心。 对世界经济复苏前景充满信心，对人类共同美好的未来充满信心。让我们同舟共济，守望相助，携手推进抗疫合作和经济复苏，共创共享亚太繁荣美好的未来。
Now, in that regard, 4 weeks ago, APEC trade ministers met together and agreed to remove any existing trade barriers and tariffs that exist for vaccines and consumables associated with the vaccine rollout. It may surprise you to know that vaccines can, in some cases, face tariffs of 6%. Vials and packaging, 20% in some cases. Syringes face tariffs. So it is a very real problem that APEC economies have the ability to remove. Whilst APEC is not generally geared up to be a clearinghouse for vaccine donations, what I do expect is that as a result of conversations, countries will be much more aware of where both surplus vaccine exists and where need for vaccine exists. And we need to continue to encourage the sharing of vaccines, particularly across those areas that are experiencing those waves. But the second strong theme was agreement and acceptance by everyone, and perhaps this was triggered by the WHO being at the beginning of our meeting, that this will not be the last pandemic we experience, and that preparedness is critical, and that whatever expense we are experiencing now as economies and as a region, with 80 million job losses, that the amount that is having to be spent to make sure that we are stimulating the economy and recovering will be much, much greater than the investment that we need to put in place to prevent a future pandemic. So there was a strong focus on the need for future prevention. I would say no. Actually, I found it to be both a productive meeting, but one in which all leaders were engaged and totally focused on the issues that we as a region face. And that, of course, includes the health response to COVID and the economic response and the role that we can all play collectively as APEC economies to accelerate our recovery. So no, that wasn't an issue that I had to navigate as chair at all.
The APEC leaders met virtually to discuss collective actions to navigate the COVID-19 pandemic and its economic impacts.
Hope you guys like this video. Please share it and also subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for latest updates. Thank you.